Well, hello and welcome to Outdoor Oklahoma. I'm Todd Craighead. Today we're putting the final touches on the soon to be open brand new public shooting range here at Pack Saddle Wildlife Management Area. Now, we recognize that clean, modern, and safe public ranges are a vital component for all kinds of shooting enthusiasts. But hunters are obviously going to benefit from these ranges, but they're not the only ones that will benefit. They're open to many other different types of recreational shooters. Now, since they're built on the backbone of hunting license dollars, everyone using our ranges will need a hunting license. A wildlife department that prioritizes the need for clean, safe, accessible shooting ranges all across the state. Just another reason to love Oklahoma and the adventures that await you.
Well, we just pulled up to this brush pile and we've already caught three. In the summertime, these fish, they get around these brush piles and structure because of the shade. And obviously there's a lot of bait fish in this area, so we've just had the shad spawn. We're using minnows to kind of mimic that. Of all the shad that are here.
We're out on Lake Eufaula. It's the dead of the summer. We've had a couple of days in the hundreds, but it's been in the upper 90s for the last several days. And we wanted to talk about today the summertime crappie fishing pattern. And we went out this morning and we drop shotted minnows and in about 6 to 8 foot of water. And the reason we chose that is the thermocline is set up in the main lake at about 8 or 10 feet, and all the fish are gonna be above that.
Another small fish.
That wind's blowing harder today than it's been blowing any day I've been out here.
A little bit better fish.
We have a brush pile in the right place right now, and the fish love it. I mean, it's just right. The bait fish are there. It's on the right flat. The channel's not too far off. We could have idled out from that brush pile out into the channel and you would have seen fish just scattered all over the place. They move in, they move out of that brush pile just because of the shad, and they get active. We pulled up on this brush pile right here and I think we've already caught 8 or 10 in like the last 5 minutes. A lot of these fish this time of year, they're mixed in. We'll be fishing it probably 30 minutes here and all of a sudden we'll catch a big one. But most of them are about 10-inch fish, good eating fish, 9 to 10 inches, and they're the best to eat, I think, so. We don't wanna be out there when it's 105 in the shade. We wanna be out there in the morning.
You just have to be smart about it. We usually try to go at daylight and we try to get off the water at noon.
We take plenty of ice chests, plenty of ice rags to keep you cool.
We don't ever leave the bank without plenty of water. plenty of other fluids, Gatorades and stuff like that with us. And then we try to be off the water. No matter how good the fishing is, we have a time frame. It gets 100 degrees. We try to be off the water by noon.
And once you find them, unless we have weather that happens, it doesn't change their pattern. They're going to be there until the temperature starts to drop.
The fish can't move deep in the summertime because of the thermocline. They have to be shallow. So we've established those patterns over the years, and it is one of our favorite times to fish.
And that pattern stays for a long time until one, the weather changes, and two, the bait fish, they move. So dog days of summer, we've come off a lot of different hatches. The threadfin shad hatch, minnow hatch, fry hatch, all that was spawning in the spring, and even the mayfly hatch, all the larvae, all the dragonfly hatch, all of that stuff that the crappie, they love to feed on.
Man, those are just good.
Just
quality,
good
eating,
quality
fish.
Eating fish.
Lord, thank you for the wind this morning.
I mean.
About a pound fish right there. You throw that one in there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Here, take it.
I got you.
You're going to keep a few of the bigger ones today.
That's even better fish.
Good fish right there.
That's a good fish. Double.
For those of you that say, hey, I don't want to travel to Lake Eufaula, this could be a pattern you need to try on your lake. The whole key to this pattern is understand the thermocline sets up. Your locator will show you the thermocline. Whatever lake you are on, when you establish the thermocline, you have to fish above the thermocline.
Oh, could have had a double. I had one on too.
There's a... Ooh.
12-inch fish.
Lost my hook. That 6-pound line went through that eye of that eagle claw hook.
The technique we use today, you can do the same thing with jigs. We probably would go to one jig. We sometimes fish with two jigs about a foot apart. The difference is, right now, you will catch about 8 to 10 to 1. Minnow versus a jig. So today, when we probably caught 50 or 60 fish in an hour and a half out there, we probably would have caught 15 or 20 using a jig.
Ooh. That's a good one.
There's you. There's what we're looking for right there. That's probably a 13-inch fish right there, maybe. I think.
Yeah, that's a 13-inch fish.
I know it's hot. Don't be afraid to get out here. Hot part of the summertime. Go in the morning. We go in the morning until about 11 o'clock, and then you can even go in the evening, 5:30 to dark. Umbrella on your boat is crucial. Towels and ice sheets, lots of ice, lots of water, lots of Gatorade. Stay hydrated, be safe, and go give this a try. You won't regret it.
We caught tons of crappie in a short period of time. You could keep your wife's attention, your kids' attention, or maybe even your friends that don't fish as much as you do. It's a great technique to catch lots of fish in a short period of time.
Welcome to the ODWC Test Kitchen. My name is Smokey Solis, and today we're gonna make barbecue swamp rabbit quesadillas. So thanks to some of our ODWC family, we were donated this giant swamp rabbit here.
smooth miss that first shot.
Now today I'm going to freestyle this recipe, and I'm just going to use some ingredients that we had in the kitchen already. So let's get to it. All right, so first off, to get this rabbit started, we're going to make a really quick barbecue sauce. This is really simple. And we're gonna slather the rabbit in it, so throw it on the grill in just a few minutes. So first off, just gonna grab your ketchup. And obviously, depending on how much barbecue sauce you want, depends on how much of this ketchup you're gonna use. I'm gonna make quite a bit here. And then inside with the ketchup, I'm just gonna add probably about a half a cup of this brown sugar here. I'm gonna add my water, and this is about of a cup, but I'm gonna add half, and we'll add as we go just in case to see how fast or how thick we want it. And then this is diced chipotle peppers in sauce. And this is something as well that I'm just gonna add to. You can always add more if you want later on, but it is pretty spicy, so we don't wanna hurt anybody. This is onion powder, just a little bit. Some paprika, give a little smoky taste. Now there is salt in that ketchup, but I'm gonna add a little bit more here. I'm gonna get a good little bit of pepper in there as well. And now we're just gonna stir this all together, mix it up good, and just let this reduce and get warm to add to the rabbit to put on the grill. All right, so we got this rabbit all slathered up with that homemade barbecue sauce. So now we're just gonna throw it on the grill. All right, so now that we've got that rabbit on the grill, we're just going to make sure that we keep putting some barbecue sauce on there until it reaches around 160 degrees. We're gonna pull it off and take it back inside. All right, so we finished up cooking that rabbit. As you can see here, looks great. You can eat it just like that, right off the bone if you'd like. But we've got some of that meat chopped up here in this bowl. And now we're just gonna take some of this rabbit meat here and put it into this quesadilla, like so. Seems like a good bit. And we're just gonna add a little more cheese into this. I'm using a Mexican blend and also some mozzarella. So let's fold this over. Now this quesadilla is packed full of greatness. Just gonna move on over to the pan. Make sure it doesn't open up on you. Just press down so it has some good surface contact on the pan. You can use the spatula to do that as well. All right, now that we pulled this sucker out of the pan, let's get it and taste it. Now we can use whatever toppings we want. I'm just gonna try it as is. That's the best thing I've had all day. So good. Go ahead and give this a shot, guys. It's really good, and it's definitely gonna hit the spot.
Red-cockaded woodpeckers are one of the quintessential black and white woodpeckers. They have a black crown and really noticeable white cheek patches. The back is black with white barring, and the chest and the belly is white with black barring. And with a name like Red Cockaded Woodpecker, you would think there would be some red patch somewhere on the head that would help you identify the bird. Instead, the white cheek patches are really the best identification feature. Adult males do have a small patch of red feathers on either side of the head, but those red patches are rarely visible. These birds are habitat specialists and rely on open, mature pine forests. In Oklahoma, that habitat is limited to the Ouachita Mountains, so historically, the birds were only found in the southeastern corner of the state. That range has gotten smaller and smaller with habitat changes, and today, the state's last remaining birds are thought to only occur on the McCurtain County Wilderness Area and the nearby Ouachita National Forest. The Wildlife Department, U.S. Forest Service, and U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service are working to improve habitat conditions for the birds. Biologists have added nesting inserts in the trees to encourage the birds to stay and nest on the area, but more importantly, they're using prescribed fire to keep the forest open and in the best condition for the birds. The red-cockaded woodpecker is federally listed by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service as an endangered species. To help monitor the birds, biologists will climb to the nest in the spring and they'll add identification bands to the chicks' legs. Then they'll do surveys in the spring and the fall to track the movements and survival of the population. For more information on Oklahoma's incredibly diverse species, check out our many resources at wildlifedepartment.com. There you can browse field guides, share wildlife sightings, and subscribe to The Wild Side, our monthly e-newsletter dedicated to non-game conservation efforts.
You see, there was this rock band from Oklahoma City, and they called themselves Knucklewide. Now see, they decided to do a little catfishing at Longmire Lake. So Luther and the boys, well, they took these rock and rollers a-tubing. Now Knucklewide's used to playing for a sea of fans. Let's see how they fare playing in front of a lake full of catfish. Now after watching Luther and the gang, old bass player Mike decided to land a hook into an old catfish for himself.
He pulled the line out.
He pulled the line out, but looks as though that fish is still on the hook.
He's coming over to net.
Just keep standing your post.
Just hold your tension on it. Hold your tension on it.
You want to go left or right?
No, just hold tension on it. Let it go. Give it to
me. Yeah.
Who's catching you, right?
All right, Alex. Come on.
As much trouble as Mike is having getting that catfish in, he might as well get his catfish at a restaurant. Well, at least Lucky was kind enough to help Blondie out.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Rock on, Mike.
Pick it on triple.
Got a good spot.
We need a different bite around here.
I caught bigger bait than you have, Luther.
Hey, Dave, what do we give a top hand award for today? Dip snuff?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
That had to taste real good. I think they make better flavors of dental floss than that. Looks like Mike is pulling in another catfish. Another now let's check one in with the others.
Kitty, kitty, kitty.
After the bass player Mike caught all the little ones, now it looks like there's only big ones left.
You gonna keep that little one?
Yep, I'm gonna keep that little one.
Take my net.
I can get my pliers, Sam. I can figure out what I done with them now.
Right under.
There we go.
Say something about giving a lesson?
He's not taking out his wisdom teeth.
I get them when I have to. I told you there's one in there.
He must be thinking 7-10 split because he's holding that catfish like a bowling ball. Ha! Doesn't like it very much, does he?
Can you grab it?
Four.
Oh my God, that's huge. That's good. Need a bag. Pretty bad. Oh! I'm trying to get over the
front of the mic,
but I just ran into
the
stuff.
Need
something to put him in.
Hey, Mike, can you grab him underneath the fence like that? Underneath the, right there.
I'm gonna eat you.
Well, not if he eats you first. Yeah. Watch out.
Quit flopping now, there.
You chill, fool.
That is so gross. Look at this.
And that's what the fish are saying underneath Denny's tube. Well, not much luck for Michael. Well, there's definitely something pulling on Blake's line. Blake sure is determined. And he's got it. He's got it. And nothing.
That's a big one.
Looks like Lucky's up to his old shenanigans again. Let's see how Luther's doing over on his side of the lake.
I got him up this much. Must have had him long ago. He's still on there. I've seen him kicking back at me. A little dink. Probably got more log than I got fish. There he is. Boy, look at him. He ain't no bigger than another. Fish bait. But I got him. I'll flop him a little now while I'm...
Is he a flopping, Mike?
He's a fight.
Yeah, no.
He's caught a shark.
That shark's going after the chum.
Look at that.
Hey!
Oh, yeah.
That's a big one there, pal.
Good fish.
Yeah, he is.
You want
to
get him?
He's taking him.
It's probably about the size of the other last one.
Now, bass player Mike has been doing really good, but just like you can plug in a bass guitar, that doesn't mean you necessarily know how to play it. Just like catching a catfish is only half the battle. Luther, why don't you help him out?
Like this right, see them fins right there?
Yeah.
If you don't knock him off, having them shorts you got on and that tube tap, sometimes we'll go pull him. Well, we just call him.
Are you going to stick me now, still?
Nah, he won't stick you now. Call it dehorning.
Right.
Now, Knuckle White has played many a shows, but not soon will they forget the show that they put on right here at Lake Longmire, where they dropped their guitars and they picked up a fishing rod. But let's hope for their sake that they stick to making music.
Well, we hope today's stories remind you that Oklahoma is a perfect place to explore. So no matter how you choose to enjoy our state's incredible natural world, remember, your adventure starts with Outdoor Oklahoma. That's a wrap. Outdoor Oklahoma is produced by the Oklahoma Department of Wildlife Conservation and is proud to serve and be funded entirely by sportsmen and women and outdoor enthusiasts who love and appreciate all things wild in the great state of Oklahoma.